What camaraderie they must have felt, these rugged Robin Hooders, dirt blending in with their suntans, torn shirts, torn neckerchiefs, nicotine-stained fingers. They move at night, learn the sky, sleep in a shepherd's shelter, a haystack, a convent, a barn, a tent in the trees made of parachute silk. Dad teaches them how to unscrew sections of rail on one side of the track so that the whole train, in one sleek motion, will gracefully subside. They are eager, dirty, and alive. This was where it started, what Dad called being his own man. How would anything ever measure up to this?
Dadland is a book about Dad. He was an incredibly unorthodox character who was, in the war, he was an SOE specialist, guerrilla agent, that was dropped behind the enemy lines and sabotage the enemy and blow up bridges and trains and things like that. You kind of think, oh, it's Dad going on a bit. But when I started researching and going into the National Archives and then finding books and then finding films with him in it, it was just astonishing to me. What he was really doing was so much bigger and so much more courageous and so much more important. And that started my journey into Dadland. But I also realised that the story was just so much bigger, and that my own journey with Dad was a huge story in itself, and all sorts of crazy, jaw-dropping, the unbelievable things that had happened in our lives were part of this story.
Dad's response to pretty much everything was usually different to everyone else's response. Rules were there not just to be broken, but to pit yourself against, to outwit. It was an intellectual exercise for him. He thought nothing of allowing us to duck out of school for a day if there was something better on. He had no respect for anything if it clashed with common sense. His, that is. On one occasion, I must have been about 12 or 13, I skived off to go riding. The next day, on the bus into school, something, the sly way Dad had licked the envelope, made me open the sick note he'd written to my teacher. One sentence. It said, "I am sorry Keggie was not at school yesterday. She had a bad hangover."
As he went into his 80s, he started having more and more serious memory lapses and began to suffer from dementia. And as that happened, he began to slowly disappear. So Dadland was my way of bringing him back. In the process, I found out a lot more astonishing things than I'd ever bargained for.
As Dad slowly leaves us, I try to haul him back from the bottom of cardboard boxes and forgotten trunks, from letters buried in desks, from books I previously had not known about, from photographs I am unfamiliar with, from diaries never meant for my eyes. I am the manic charity shop rummager rifling through old clothes. I don't know why I have taken on this task. As it is, I have been under the gravitational pull of his influence far too long. Except that suddenly I need to make some sense of it all. It's not just Dad I want to stick back together again. This is an exorcism and a ghost hunt. Rebuild him, rebuild me.